Hello and welcome back to another episode of XCOM 2, Long War of the Trolls. My name is Syken and today we're having a very special mission, Operation Magic Tears, where we are finally liberating Australia, a region that has a solid strength of 9 and a vigilance rating of 19. So things are popping up there. We're fighting against 50 enemies and we got the good old Blood Angels ready and able. So let's go into the mission. No. Let's go into the mission and give it a go. All right, we landed. So this is us against 50 enemies.
Roger that.
That will be a tough sell. Let's take a slow and methodological approach.
Confirmed.
Anders, aviator, Aaron, Renman, Death Knell, and Hawkeye. Okay, good firing line. I think overall decent position that we do have. Question of the day will be, when are we breaking concealment? And okay, this pack is moving away, whatever. When are we breaking concealment? So what's the right trigger for that?
I will go.
And where do we want to fight? Got a turret there. One turret alone is not enough for me to consider breaking concealment.
Confirmed. Got eyes on a hostile squad. Affirmativo.
But I can definitely say more enemies would motivate me. Alright, going all the way to the edge so that our squad side penalties aren't that big.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Is it
on Overwatch scanning?
I'm on it.
None EV detection. Overwatch.
For a single turret, I wouldn't break concealment, but say if the pack of the mutants comes back, I would consider just getting it down. Drones might be an option as well. I think we could do that. Death Knell could be our front line. And having a hunter drone as a mimic beacon, I could definitely see that. Well, so much for our mimic beacon, eh?
Let's get well shielded.
Nah. Necessarily enough to actually trigger the Overwatch.
Order confirmed.
They come a little bit closer than fine. Bit salty that the drone takeover didn't work, but luckily we do a failsafe so we did not lose concealment. Okay, so these guys would come in next turn after we triggered.
Roger.
Good, that is a steady pipeline. I'm okay with it. Let's break concealment. Just get the enemy down. Just don't trigger that pack yet. Oh, there's another turret. And, so two turrets, that I would say is definitely worth it. Let's get the hunter drone down.
Moving to designated position.
Good. I want everybody to get the shield, so Plisket for now. Let's move over here. Nice little null ward. Let's try to hit that heavy turret. Good, that's one down. Did I just see a third turret up here? Oh yeah. Well, not too bad. In that case, we're just going to clean up the turrets.
Stiamo tenendo i punteggi.
Got it covered. Scanning.
That pack should trigger. There were plenty of shots. Yeah, our Overwatch was never great. Okay. You know, it would be one thing if it is a Spectre with lightning reflexes and you just can't hit it. But a mutant, of all of the aliens, the least agile unit that you could imagine, and we're missing the shots. Yeah. Overwatching. Okay. Cool. Cool. Okay. Needed to take a short break, so. How do we deal with these guys? I think one efficient way is to get up here, remove the Overwatch and deal some damage. Might as well hit three. Could we hit three? Could we hit three? No, we can only hit two, but that is good enough. Starting to injure you. Of course, just a grazing hit. Starting to kill you. Oh, come on. Why so little damage, bruh? That is not cool. That won't be a kill, but heavy injury. Nice crit. Like it.
I got it, right?
Ne vale la pena? Moves over here. Who's over here? Starting to hit you. Good crits, good crits.
Whatever you say.
Moves into full cover. Almost able to take out that stupid Spectre. Alright, lots of damage. We can still move into cover.
Keep going.
Yeah, let's just make sure that we cannot be immediately flanked. That would be great. And it would be even better if we could actually kill one of them. Thank you. Elsewise, this would have been a nasty display of how to not engage. I will use the command to reload. Renvin's only weakness is the lack of ammunition. 5 is good as a magazine count, but it still goes down very quickly if you are shooting and rapid firing every round. I bet you it's somewhere back here. And I can't get close enough. This here would be dangerous because we're looking through the window. Could try to do this. Okay, lucky. Good, we can definitely reload afterwards. Another turret down. Reload here, normal overwatch, and I would like us to move to here. I think the high ground isn't too bad. Deathknell has the same problem. He needs to reload very frequently.
La via libera.
Tired of waiting around.
Good, we're getting into a solid position again. Overwatch. Plisket begins to carefully scout out.
We've got a hostile squad here.
I figured that might be a problem.
Scanning. Mi tengo pronto.
Come get some.
Is that a rainbow pack? Yeah. Complete pack. Which means the others will join soon as well. Captain charges forward, eats 10 points of damage like a boss, and just stays there. Wow. Good, we need to get this guy down. C- could use a grenade, but I might need that later, and to be fair, I think we, 80%, that should be a kill.
Missed the target.
Okay. Not exactly what I was expecting. It's a bit problematic because I wanted death from above for reload on the sniper, which now is no longer going to work. Not cool. Okay, we got another one that we could kill. Let's try to hit the heavy gunner and get him down. That worked well. Renman gets some comet presence, and unfortunately we're out of ammunition, but at least the enemies are dead. Purifier takes a nice little hit. Not the cleanest of all turns, I might say. Let's get some loot.
Target asset located.
And Overwatch. Okay, we killed about half of the rainbow pack. Grenadier is still alive. Purifier is still alive. Shieldbearer is still alive, and I think there should be a priest. Might be a stun lancer as well. Nah, there's the priest. Okay, first things first, I think we will get the purifier down. Oh wow. Thank you. Definitely well armored. Secondly, we need to reload here. And the only target that we really have available is the stupid priest. And I don't feel like gambling on a death from above, so we're reloading. And we're just going to mark him instead. Good enough. More reload, as you can see. The prolonged exchange has taken its toll. Okay, good. Oh, fantastic. Not even sustenance, overkill. Great. I do have a problem. This pack might add, and that's definitely not in our interest.
Let's do this.
We're moving forward because I want to use the flamethrower. Just in case we're being spotted out, let's use fortify and reload as well. Overwatch here. Reload and pistol overwatch. Okay, that's fine. And Aaron doesn't have any temp hit points anymore, so might as well give them some. One more round and then we can create another barrier. There we go. Stupid shield bearer moves in. It's given everybody here shields, so Stun Lancer follows. Double moves and is in a really good spot for us to kill. What's a massive pack. Oh, look at you. Lots of suppression here. Okay. So. This guy needs to die. This guy needs to die. And we want to control over here. To use any of that yet. What we can definitely do is get some so that everybody here is a bit better off.
Repositioning.
Nice little position. Up here. Let's get the juicy Stun Lancer up here.
You are judged.
All right, didn't happen. In the meantime, Shield Bearer. One hit. And a kill to get the shields down. Okay, next up we will break their stupid Overwatch.
Let's move already.
Lightning hands. Definitely going to flamethrow this. That'll be four hits. Yeah. Fantastic. Burning, 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 which means only the Centurion can act. Let's remove Overwatch, or the suppression rather. Close but no cigar, as they say. Null ward. provides extra temporary hit points. Stun Lancer has a cool position there. Somehow we can't really see him. And I'm mildly afraid that he will jump out of there and be like, yeah, surprise. Look what I got you. Tries to hit the mutant. This mutant is already not acting, so might as well overwatch. Aviator moves into a secure position over here. We're doing another overwatch. These guys are just burning. Ah, the Centurion. I forgot about the Centurion. It's not the end of the world because they does not have any really good targets, but still. And he might just move into fire, right? So that's always a possibility. This, however, is unfortunate because now the Stun Lancer kill that could have happened is not happening. This guy is dead. It could have been worse. Renman luckily had enough temporary hit points to make this one work. I don't want to explode that. We're reloading first because that's easy, and then we'll get a lot of shots. Why wouldn't I reload? Because I get hit and run, and after hit and run I get a kill, and that trigger is implacable, and the skirmisher is just overall a great hero. Going for the Centurion. Steadying our own weapon.
Adjusting aim. That's how it's done.
Reloading. Whenever there's nothing to do, reload is a good option. We know that one more mutant is on the other side.
Locked and loaded. Ready to go.
Might as well use the time really to decent the reload.
Roger that.
Get a little bit closer in and switch sides so that we're not being flanked. That is the sound cue for them running back. Good, let's double check where the last enemies are. We still could move out. I don't want to trigger a whole bunch of enemies. Moves this way without a grappling hook and nothing triggered. Okay, cool. Well, good time to start moving forward.
Moving to position.
I'll take the loot.
I have the asset. Rolling.
And let's move as a ball of death. Kind of Overwatch crawl.
Stepping off. Got it, moving. Moving to Overwatch.
Okay, we're going to take the high ground. This building here seems like the best choice. Very wide. Good angles.
Enemy patrol on the move.
Got two more turns until we can get shields back.
Let's do this.
Careful with the fire here, Syken.
Got it.
I think we also need to reload. Okay, Overwatch here.
Scanning.
Reload for death now.
Moving to Overwatch.
And we should be okay. Let's take this high ground, and then once the drones are a little bit further away, we can take the front. We'll keep you here for now. Let's begin to move over here.
I can handle that. Affirmative.
Placable definitely needs to reload.
Sure thing.
Moving to Overwatch. Got it covered.
Good, solid position up here for now. Going to move over next turn. Perfect. Very good timing. That allows us to move a little bit closer. Very good.
Order's confirmed. Moving out.
Anything over here? No. Good, Renven can overwatch even after a double move thanks to ever vigilant. Implacable as a sniper there. Together with Dead Eye. Anders there. Nah, that's not a good position. Aviator typically should be at the front line, but currently that's not possible.
Overwatch.
We will jump down soon, but I think for the first turn, let's just overwatch and stay together as a unit. Okay.
Okay.
I said okay, he says okay. I like his obedience. Time to move forward. Big fat barrier for everyone.
No problem, boss.
Hey, Aaron moves down. Spots out the turret, but that's okay. We can kill the turret. The camera does not reveal any other packs. Let's spread out as much as I feel comfortable. Okay, a bit of damage, and that'll be a kill and a reload finally. Next up, let's find those drones. Well, good news is we don't need to look for them, and they already found us. Raising rounds, okay.
Impressed yet?
Good, steady the weapon. Good, very good. We got a very nice overview.
It's still moving.
And unfortunately are being flanked. Well, Berserker does what a Berserker does, right? Charges in. Not too bad. Good. Or not so good. We got a couple of intruders over there. And as you can imagine, I do not appreciate being surprised like that. We're using lightning hands as free actions. Good. Berserker is learning an important lesson here. You know what? Let's try to get that Viper. I just mind control her? Oh yeah, baby. Viper mind control confirmed. Good, that's one berserker down. And with it, I think we get a nice little implacable. Can only mildly advance. Not massively. At the same time, let's just go over here. Throwing a grenade, that's taking away a bit of the cover, but not really helping the case with cover. Listen, we'll just continue plowing through that berserker. Nice little shredding. Deals a lot of damage and makes the berserker susceptible for more aggressive damage. We'll move up. Fortify so that we can properly frontline. Hitting the berserker, hitting him very well. Handing over teamwork. Before shooting the berserker ourselves.
Gonna need to reload soon.
We could kill and at least get implacable. That is one option. What's our chance to hit the mutant? Not too bad either. I think we also do have our snipers, so might as well just use this here. Implacable failed. Take him down. Look, that's a solid chance to actually kill him. Very good. We got some further movement to do. And let's just CC the remaining advent. Very good. Nicely disoriented. Just double checking that we're not running into more enemies. Okay, well, that was a quick reality check. I'll use the Viper in order to pull that other pack. Okay. Let's carefully start. That was already wrong, but whatever. We got combat presence, so might as well use it. Tongue pull this guy out of cover. That's a hit for hit and run. And that's a kill. Let's get the loot. Next up, I want to get rid of the turret. Good damage. Reloading.
Reloaded. Tired of waiting around.
Good hit.
I'm running low.
Let's kill it. We would have even only gotten it one more round, so there is no downside in doing that.
Seems doable. If you say so. Scanning. Ricarica eseguita. We're green to go.
Might have used poison spit here in order to block off that area, but okay, whatever. I want to get regain cooldowns anyways and get a bit of a better position. This pack is definitely tricky to deal with. Maybe we're going a tiny bit more this is a good aiming angle per se. We need to reload first. I'm seeing just an enormous amount of reloads that are necessary. Plus, we're a bit out of position. I don't really like our position that we find ourselves in. Okay, apparently they are coming a bit closer now. It starts becoming interesting if we can reach them with a rocket and hit all of them at once. That would be worth it.
Whatever you say. Finally.
That's a problem. Someone is over here. That is a big problem. Snipers are closest to them, and I do not want that to happen.
Solid copy.
Affirmative.
Va bene.
Next round is a go. Just giving everybody extra hit points.
I'm on it. On overwatch. Confirmed. Eyes on the prize.
Well, now we do have a problem. Let's hope that the general's pack is not going to continue rushing towards us and instead just stays there. It does. Which is reassuring. mean, that would be the easy and obvious solution, but I think we can make it work even without that solution. Get rid of Overwatch, thank you. This is solid cover. And will give us hit and run that we need. Come on. Good hit. Removes the remaining Overwatch.
That's right.
That guy is down as well. We are auto-targeting the Centurion, who's arguably one of the more difficult targets to get down. Good, now we're locked on. And let's kill the Centurion. Come on, two hits. Almost. Very nice hits, but not level, unfortunately.
La mente è la mia arma. Sai che roba.
Could hit him from where we are. Okay, this should dampen them down a little bit. Stunned, disoriented. Did we kill him? Yeah, the explosion killed him. And another stun, which means the berserker is fully taken out. Should have done the chain shot before the smoke appeared. That would have given us a better chance of hitting.
Affirmative, covering now. Good copy, moving on target.
Good, stay there and don't move closer. Wow, can't believe that they're actually doing what I'm telling them to do. Alright, come on. Good hit. Fantastic one.
What did you expect?
Okay, just in case, insanity. He's now panicked, and we might be able to kill him. Nope.
Mancato. Ready to rock.
Ready to engage. Doing the reload and the kill. I have to wonder, should I move forward? Potentially not. If they come in, they will come in fully. So we're good. Reload Overwatch. Overwatch. More Overwatch. Okay, end of turn. And of course, yep, it was clear as daylight that they would not just stay there. Oh wow, what a nice setup. That's full cover, by the way. So good. Good, so this is going to be the money shot. So, okay, cool. Fortify. Give me that sweet, sweet rocket. I would call that a partial hit. Frontline gets the 8 protocol, and then let's see. We had hit this guy here with red screen rounds, so maybe they are hackable. Good chance, but not good enough. Was worth a try. In absence of that being an option, we're just going to eliminate it, of course. Get some for everyone. Longbow, come on. More like Mech Dead Bow. Mech Archer.
That's how it's done.
Reloading. Mind merge for extra hit points. Before we're overwatching. That'll be a kill. Justice. Dirty laughter. And there is another kill. Fantastic. This guy still lives. We have decimated the pack massively. And a little bit further to the right so that rockets are not going to hit all of them. Wow, 8 points of shredding damage. That's a lot, even for XCOM standards. Almost got that thing down. That should not trigger. Removing Overwatch. Well, that was a decent hit. Forward. More combat presence. Let's hope both of them are very much susceptible to fire damage. Because that's what you get. Big fat flamer. Oh yeah, burning and burning. Nice. Moves to here, and let's start hitting him.
They hit the plate.
Armor penetration is good. Not perfect, but it is a start. I want to keep concealment if possible. But there is a realistic chance that we might not be able to keep concealment. For now, everybody focuses on him. Good, more burning damage. So many hit points. Okay, effectively moves from one full cover to the other.
Can we shred him somehow? We're pretty low on our shredding capacities.
It's killing time. Maintaining position.
Why did I just hunker down? That was not clever. I clicked auto targeting, but I think it just didn't register. Can we disorient him or maybe even panic him? No. The answer is you cannot. He's just too much of a boss to be mildly disturbed by that. We're moving into a flanking position that hopefully does not trigger anything. And with flanking, we're getting more damage. Very good. Just a couple of crits here. That's how we do it. This will get us locked in. Let's rupture him. Great hit. And he's ruptured, which will give us extra damage against him. Let's be greedy and try to kill him. Almost down, almost down.
I can handle that.
Bit atypical that Aaron would go to the front line, but the proximity and the aiming angle allowed him to get this guy down. Not the last pack though. Let's just double check. Nothing. Okay. Might be here, might be here.
I'm going.
I'm moving back. I like our general position, so
if you say so.
Don't want to deviate too far from that.
So.
We have no more heavy weapons, we're out. So one of the things that I would do is just get everybody in a decent position, reload here, steady weapon, reload Overwatch, and let's find out if the last pack is somewhere here. There's definitely another turret.
No problem, boss.
And what we could do is haywire that and take over the turret to get some view. There are more turrets. I see how it is.
You know that was good.
Can hardly imagine that the couple of turrets are the reason why this map is still going. But turrets are a problem overall if you don't eliminate them. But thanks to our sniper and our setup here, we are in a fine, in an absolute good position to eliminate whoever is coming, really. Moving a tiny bit further forward.
Tired of waiting around.
Need to reload.
Let's do this.
I'm on it.
But I'd say we're good. Oh, look at that. I think we found our last pack. correction, I think there is more than one pack. Gosh, so many enemies on this map. Definitely lost count, but it feels more than 50. I don't know if it is true, but it does feel more than 50 enemies.
Moving on target location.
We are in a fortunate position, in one where we can start molesting the enemies whilst they cannot do much against us. Oh yeah, let's get that grenadier. Very good, 16 points of damage, and these guys are almost down. So it's a good setup here. Moving to there. Moving to there.
Moving to Overwatch. Affirmative, covering now. Zulina left. Overwatch.
Okay, I would assume slowly but surely these guys are going to run towards us. Gotta commend their bravery for doing that. If you would see that your comrade is being shot by a sniper, you would not, I assume, you would not just charge in like a madman. But not so Advent. Advent is aggressive as ever. And comes up with a couple of new strategies, aka the full rush, the Zerg rush. Nah, let's get the archer. Mechs need to die. And mech archers in particular. Steady the weapon. Going to get the purifier. The grenadier, sorry. He lashed down right there. Okay, cool. I think we're bracing for impact now, as they should be here any moment.
Mi tengo pronto. I'm on it. On Overwatch. I'm on it. Overwatch. I will not waver.
Oh, whoa. Whoa, indeed.
I got it, right?
Sector is beginning to move in. And we've now entered the age of indirect warfare. They are summoning. Whilst we are trying to just get them down. Oh, now they're even giving the summoning Holy Warrior. Okay, cool. But I think we're going to be fine. Null ward protects everyone nicely. Okay, zombie goes down.
Okay,
moving up here. Good, we can move back right after that. Want to get the look. Oh, I thought we had implacable. Never mind, I just wasted our one action. We can move back. Let's get the scout, and I think we need to reload afterwards.
Impressed yet? Ready to go.
That's a flanking shot. Maybe crit. Just a flanking shot for now. And we're moving back. That'll force him to move in, wasting one action and preventing his stupid stasis play. That was a mistake. That was a big, fat mistake.
Check it before you get too close. I'm trusting you here.
Interesting. But this very nice flanking shot has still just scratched him.
You know that was good.
That indeed was very good. Unfortunately, we can't pull a sectoid out of his cover. For whatever reason, he's too heavy to be pulled.
Rock and roll.
nella tua testa.
I think there is just one drone left, if I'm not mistaken. Good, we yet again got another unit under our control. I like this long-ranged warfare. Very different playstyle to normal XCOM, where there's always a timer. This feels slightly imbalanced in your favor, which for a change is not too bad.
Positive confirmation. Area secured. Status confirmed.
And that was 60 enemies. It honestly felt more. It felt like more. Think about it, 60 enemies. Yeah. Maybe it was just because I was interrupted so often in the mission, but that felt definitely more like 100. Huge packs. My favorite fight of that mission was the last long-range engagement, where we were basically scouting out, and then all Advent could do was rush into us and give us a hard time. But the snipers absolutely destroyed them. Not even close. So, close encounters. Oh yeah, we got level, which is great. That we're going to take level. Yep, level it is. Really, really, really good. Okay, Aaron is the first specialist to reach Master Sergeant level. Restoration is great, I like that. Gremlin Discharge. I always liked that, and Killzone per definition is a nice ability. Of course it is better if you do have functions like Ever Vigilant, right? Covering fire and repressive fire. But Killzone in itself with a full magazine can be a game changer, specifically since I'm tending to play with the specialists a little bit further back. So I'm thinking, and bear with me for the train of thought at the moment. So far, the sheer amount of temporary hit points really made restoration not necessary. It's a great ability. I absolutely love it, and I think in a clutch situation, there is no single ability that could keep your team going so much more than restoration. The problem is, I'm already smashing the game quite heavily, and we do have 4 heals, which have not even been used. We could skill Savior, again, hasn't been used. Capacitator Discharge, on the other end, is a stun, and robotic units take more damage. That's not bad either, just an AoE stun, and it has a long range. It has one charge though. Killzone, if I had Sentinel, this would definitely make a lot of sense. I think I'll capacitate the discharge in the main team. In the Grey Knights, we're going to kill zone. On the other hand, think about it. Do you really need capacitated discharge? Need is such a strong word. Not necessarily need. It deals a decent amount of damage with an upgraded gremlin, of course. And robotic units take extra damage. So a pack like the one that we've seen would be completely obliterated by capacitated discharge. No question.
This here could be 6-7 shots, even not upgraded. And since I play with the specialists a little bit further back, it essentially for once gives them squad side. So you can make a strong argument for kill zone as well, just because it adds a lot of pressure. I think we're going with kill zone. Place good. Reaper, thank you. I like that. We could go lightning hands if we wanted. Or we're just waiting for return fire, potentially not necessary. Yeah, I'll think about it. And implacable. Flashbanger is a nice trait. I also like smoker, just having those available as options from time to time are actually quite nice. I could see reload smoker to solidify a position. On the other hand, there are a couple of other topics as well, such as face-off, which is really good when we're anyways having a pistol, right? Quick draw, not so much for a sniper. Sometimes you could quick draw and then steady weapon, but that's pushing it. Or you could lightning hands, quick draw, if kind of the hit point setup of targets is specific to that. Okay, so let's start with the top one. Deadeye is potentially what we're going to do. Aggression isn't bad either. They do have a lot of extra damage with the crits. So let's go with aggression. I want to test that. 30 extra crit isn't bad at all. Now the question is, I think we're going to get face off later. For now, we don't need that. Haywire, on the other hand, long watch is good. I like that she has 14 points. Not being able to be crit is huge. Untouchable is great as well. I think we're just going for untouchable for her. Although the pistol skills, like I said, are good on them as well. And we have a lot of loot. Good, so I think that was overall quite successful. The Blood Angels are mostly ready, with the exception of Implacable, who is tired, but generally speaking, for such a long mission, they were actually doing very well. And it's funny because the Blood Angels, there are a couple of Master Sergeants already in them, and then they do have very low level characters as well, so strange leveling between all of them. They, I think, are the ones with the most Master Sergeants overall, even more than the Grey Knights, who took it upon them to kind of infiltrate a little bit longer. But that's actually weird. That's very weird. How comes that these guys have 18 missions? Did I just do so many missions with them? Hogbite, on the other hand, has 16 missions. Okay, well, it's just Renman has had so many kills. And even Aaron, I had 19 missions. I just did the most missions. That's it. But it also tells us that very soon more Master Sergeants are going to come up. Overall, the roster is looking healthy, so we're actually doing very well for ourselves. Thank you. Last thing, no recruits. And if I recall correctly, oh, there are new rookies, that's good, we're going to take that. If I recall correctly, we had another mission ready to go. Oh no, we had done the network tower mission here, and we're now theoretically ready for another liberation there. Good. You will go to supply. We leave two people on recruitment duty. And I would like to put Oliver right into here. Wondering, it's only 279. This here is 222. Maybe that is just because the rest of the month is only 8 days long, but. Yeah, okay. I see. We have earned 137 out of 222, and we've earned 0 out of 60. Okay, so yeah, we're going to earn more money. That is important, and there's going to be some more recruitment. Let's just keep 3 on recruiting and the rest on supplies. Just making sure that the team fills up completely. Okay, cool. So that brings us to the next challenge, which is HQ assault here is going. This region here has strength 2, so there is still plenty that we can do. No need to rock the boat yet. These guys here are now at strength 5 because they have received quite a few units, and one unit went over here. So yeah. Okay, well, it is what it is. I think we are going to take more rookies. That would be great. And I'm hoping for more missions, specifically in South Africa and over here. So let's just double check. We are fully on intel with a little bit of recruitment. Why would we recruit here, Syken? That is not necessary. You already have 13 people here, and this should spawn a lot of missions, like a lot of missions. And down here we do have the option to do some more missions as well. 13 here is good. Let's put a scientist over here. Wanted to make sure that we're using the two regions that we do have, East Asia and South Africa, to the fullest extent. And now we could theoretically make contact, but we have already done that, so no point in doing that. The real kicker in terms of spending intel will be once we liberate this region, because then we can go doop doop doop, and that'll be a huge benefit. For now, let's start to scan for rookies. New Indonesia have recovered from Chosen's. Oh, okay. That means we're earning more money going forward. Great.
The outcome of this research can only further our advances.
Advanced coil guns, perfect, and a couple of instant stuff. So instant mutant autopsy gives us a couple of items, actually. Not important. That, however, is a bit more important, because it'll give the skirmisher more melee power. Tactical vest is cool because it gives armor and more hit points. Plasma grenade, very good. I unfortunately
They removed the better cover destruction property, so it is just as good as a normal grenade, but it deals more damage, which is not bad. We got the mech breakdown. And holotargeter, okay. Played a bit, that is not bad because it allows better hacking. And blue screen protocol, that is also very good because it allows blue screen rounds, and in time we're going to do that. We now have an inspired, so 2 days off, leaving it from 12 to 10 days coil guns, which we're definitely dumping our money into, because that will give us the option not only for advanced coil guns, but we're also getting more supplies. We're also getting plasma weapons, and with more supplies coming in, we will be able to definitely get plasma weapons at some point. Could use another engineer, to be honest, so the shielding power coil is a bit slow, but I don't mind too much at the moment. Okay, we got two rookies. Let's take a look at what we're dealing with. We got 31 Zilu. That looks like a Psy operative to me. And we got a 72 hit chance. Bit slow, but good hit points. So that's a great gunner if we need one more, or a sniper or a ranger. So assaults are okay. We got grenadiers. In terms of grenadier training, we got effectively one more grenadier. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 gunners. That seems fine as well. A lot of psi operatives, which isn't bad. Could do another ranger. A few more sparks. We need to build more. We got a few sharpshooters. That's fine as well. Shinobis are looking good. We actually don't need a class. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Specialists. Do we have? Yeah, 7s in training. Okay. And technicals. Okay. So we can make him anything we want. Maybe another gunner, because we didn't have that yet on our squad management. What do we have down here? We do have a gunner, we do have a sniper, we do have a ranger, so we have all of the shooty classes, which means we're really free to get whatever we feel is necessary. I personally like the gunners a lot because of their innate ability to shoot that often on relatively low ranks, so that helps with a lot of the chosens, for instance. Okay, cool, so that's fine. I believe we want to continue with healing. We have good resources, and once I sell more stuff at the black market, we should be fine. Finally, 10 days. That is a great mission for a beginner squad. So we could use the Imperial Fists once they are done. We could also, now they are still tired. I mean, we could Ultramarines plus a couple of friends, so to speak, that come onto this mission. These guys need 5 days training anyways, and jammer training, so that's as easy of a mission as it gets. Do we have a Psy operative that would be ready? What do we need to do? Extract advanced supplies? Okay, I'll get a team together. Okay, it's 5 days and just a little bit to
to infiltrate that. Very good. Do we really have that many wounded soldiers? Because I continue just trying to heal, and I'm not sure if that is even a smart decision. 6, 7, 9. Yeah, we do have a few, so extra healing is good. I'm not sure if it works for tired as well. Would be cool if it reduces the tire time equally, but unlikely. Very good. We're going to quickly train the rookie, which you can see takes only 2 days, so we're doing a bit of a quick rotation with the training so that we can get the guys back into combat. One other train of thought. No, we already have officer training going. That's good. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. 3 days, 22 hours could actually be very good. Could actually be very good, specifically since we get full salvage. We just need to reach 100%, and I'm willing to boost that. So Blood Angels or Grey Knights, we're still a bit tired here with the Grey Knights, so Blood Angels it is. I have put Plisket on the other mission in anticipation that we wouldn't need him. So now we have brought ourselves into a bit of a problematic position, but we can take one more. I think that's pretty much all we could muster. Cover removal, damage, crowd control, support. I think that's an okay SWAT, to be precise. And we could get up to 20 enemies plus their bodies. We also can prevent Advent from moving in here. Let me just equip everybody. All right, so
in position to drop.
That'll be interesting. Let's boost the infiltration here, and we definitely want to get that supply rate. That'll give us quite a few corpses and will protect the strengths here from going up. Because what's happening is strength 5 is now, of course, trying to push over to here. And we do not want that to happen anytime soon.
Setting course for Indonesia.
Okay, we got ourselves a new Psy operative. And what are the options here? Plenty of quick options, I like it. Phase War could lead into the cover destruction, Soul Steal into the bigger nukes that are available. I like the teleportation a lot because it's just incredibly good, together with cover removal. That'll be even more utility. You can also teleport and then cover remove, then the template kind of switches position positions with you afterwards. So face walk, good. Plenty of little tricks that you can do in order to make that one work. Good, we got the Hunter's Axe, that is helpful. And someone somewhere has infiltrated 100%. I have to wonder This is already extremely light, and that is our training squad, so might as well do that mission next at 125%. What else do we have? Extract VIP from the salamanders over here. They also can execute, and that would get both of them back up into availability, which would be helpful. In the meantime, whilst you guys are recruiting, let's speed up the recruitment process by having Sam be your guide. That should, with such a with the master sergeant, that should drastically improve our recruitment. Up here, Dranks could also do that. Both of them we can get back in time. Yeah, just overall the recruitment activities. Let's speed them up just a tiny bit. Since all of them are okay on their willpower, we might as well put them into good roles. So seems legit to me. Soon the Grey Knights will be ready for the next HQ assault. So we do have a lot of things going on at the same time. A few VIP extractions, which will be helpful. Here we are looking for a Ranger. That is good. That'll give us a Sergeant right away. And up here we do have another scientist, and you know, you very much know that they are great and that we should get them.
Our cooperation has proven to be a boon to the resistance.
We just got some new intel on the Chosen. Pretty soon we'll be able to take them down permanently.
My followers grow increasingly reverent of your ability.
Recruit another Templar. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Opportunity for you to assign
reduce Avatar Project.
Them to share some new information.
Oh, another Templar would be nice. But reduction of the Avatar Project is also not bad. I think we can afford to do that now. No, it's not John McMullen. Let's do Igor here. And let's do Euler. And Azizal, Darkrai, the three that are always doing these missions. Getting another Templar, mwah, that would be fantastic. I'm always looking for Primarchs for our teams. And that for one of the chapters, and that would definitely be a good Primarch, being another Templar on a lower level team. As the teams are now getting higher, once they are at maximum experience, I will potentially just use them for the really difficult missions, HQ assaults, supply raids, and so on. And we're going to see a few newcomers. I'm just going to build up a healthy roster of more and more chapters. And yeah. So that'll be the idea. I think in terms of finding the Chosen next month, we might want to infiltrate the stronghold slowly but surely and begin finding the Chosens, because then we can take them out of the game. That would be a huge game changer. Good. That's it for today. Super long mission. I appreciate your viewership, and if you've made it that far, kudos. Leave a comment down below and let me know which fight you liked most of the HQ assault, and see you on the next episode. Bye bye.